Can we please take a minute and talk about my wonderful plaster? Huh? I'm a grown up, by the way. Grown up. Hi guys, this is Connie, and today's video is going to be pretty different from what I used to upload here on this channel. This is a pretty personal video, and if you don't want to listen myself because you have your crap to deal with, just feel free to look for something else on YouTube. Maybe come when I will upload something more art related, like a speed paint or a tutorial, whatever else. And I just want to say that I totally understand if you don't want to deal with what I'm about to say, and if you are not watching this video at all, I'm just okay with it, because I know it's really difficult for people to understand or even listen to other people's complaints or rants, and vloggish kind of videos are not for everybody. So as I said, no harsh feeling, just feel free to go somewhere else. But I think this is a video that I should have done before, and that you guys kind of deserve some kind of explanation from me. As the title suggests, I will talk about why I've been off YouTube lately and why I don't update that often, and I would really love to talk about my view on art block as well. So I will try to keep this thing real and not joke too much about things, because that's what I do. I tend to just put myself down or hide behind sarcasm because it's easier to deal with crap like this. And I might use more harsh terms in this video because I don't care about it being demonetized or whatever it's called, the thing. I'm not making any money out of YouTube anyway, so why should I care? But if you are sensitive about words like crap or things like that, I'm really sorry. I will try to be clean, but at the same time, I want to be real, and that involves me kind of swearing from time to time. I'm so sorry. Really, I'm so sorry. But as I said, this is going to be pretty much just me talking. I don't plan on putting any speed paint on video, so if you're waiting for art, it's probably not going to happen. It's just me talking with an open heart to you guys. And as I said, I want to make this thing more real as I can. So, the reason I've not been on YouTube or any social media really is because, it's because of how I deal with things. And before I go into more details, I just want you to know that English is not my first language, so I might slip here and there, and just please forgive my bad English, because this is what matters, is the meaning, it's not the form. Okay, so I've not been on YouTube or any other platform because I am in a really bad place. I've been in a really bad place for years now, and I've been there for most of my life, really. I've been struggling with depression for as long as I can remember, but somehow I managed to not get out of it, because you don't really get out of it, but take small breaks from time to time, and I don't want to be too cheesy, but the only analogy I can think of is a monster. I know it's already been used and used, but that's real. It's something that consumes you from the inside, and it's something that you can maybe try to fight, but you will never, never, ever leave it behind, because it's a part of you. It's depression is something that builds you. It's part of your matter. Yeah, it's part of your matter. You're not just going to feel cured, because yeah, it's there. Even if you are not listening to that monster that's whispering in the back of your head, it's still there. And if you are lucky enough, you just stop listening, or just put something louder and go on and hope to have good days, good months, maybe even good years. But it's still here, it's still there, and you can feel it, I can feel it. And as I said before, I dealt with depression for most of my time. But there was something at a certain point triggering me to just start and try to be better. I'm not going into details, but I had pretty severe cases in which I was a problem for myself and others, and somehow I managed to get over it by myself, sort of. And I always try to get over it by myself. I relied on some close friends, but in the end, what really started the get better for me was myself, was something inside of me, some kind of I wanted something so bad that I just wanted to fight with all I got to grab that thing, to achieve that thing. And could have been small things or big things, but motivation was what helped me. Sorry. Is what helped me to get over it. And most people don't even know what it is like. Most people think that if you smile, or if you were depressed and now you like walk around the home, or you meet friends, or you just laugh and joke about things, even things that happened that were terrible for you, you are healed, you are now whole again. But you are never whole again. You can never be whole again. If there's something missing, if the space that should be filled with good thing is just a hole that is sucking up your happiness or what's left of it, you are not going to be whole again. Because there's this thing that's piercing you, and you can fill it with other stuff, but it will never be your stuff. You know, it's like if you put a patch on something, that something has a patch. It's not whole again. It looks like it can be whole again, but it's not. And I'm so sorry if this is abstract or too silly for you, but the thing is that people often do not understand how hard it is. They just think that you're sad, and when you are depressed, you're just sadder. But it's not that. It's not just being sad or emotional. It's just, it's not having motivation at all. And I personally found out that this time for me is different because I don't want anything. I fake to want something because I want to pretend it. Like, I want to fake it until I make it. I want to fake interest in doing something so that I can actually put effort into doing something to get X, right? But the truth is that I don't have anything right now that I want. And I can't see myself wanting something so badly for me to refight. I kind of want to be better, to feel better, but it's more something that I know it's good for me. Like, I know it's healthy for me to wish to be better. But that's all. I don't really care. I'm in that hole of sadness and desperation and self-deprecation, and I don't see myself climbing out of that tunnel of desperation anytime soon because it's not the best place to be in, but at least it doesn't hurt that much because I've fallen down here lots of times. Too many times, and right now I'm so tired, I don't even care. And I feel ungrateful because I'm pretty much healthy and I live a decent life, but at the same time, I cannot accept all of what happened, all of what could happen, all of my failures. I cannot, and it hurts so much when it. When I fall, that I just. I want. It's not that I want that, but for me, it's better to just be in this kind of stasis than being hit that hard again. I don't like being disappointed. Nobody likes it, but I'm in a point in my life in which disappointment is really tearing me apart. And when I'm in this kind of situation, I don't want people to know that I'm hurt. I don't want people to know that I'm feeling uncomfortable. I don't want to be the kind of person that is, you know. I don't want people to pity me. I don't want sympathy. I don't want this. And I'm a very proud person, so I just prefer not showing anything at all. I'm not there. You can't ask me questions because I'm not there. So I'm just doing other things. Maybe I'm busy. Maybe I'm not. You wouldn't know it. Right? And then I will be back and I will have the strength to say, yeah, I had a crappy period, or no, I was busy, depending on what happened. Because when I'm bad, when I'm feeling really bad, as I said before, I don't want people to know that I'm bad, that I feel like crap. I don't want that. And I've always been like this. I've never been able to. I'm not fake, okay? If I don't like something, I will tell you. I think I'm a pretty honest person, but I just don't like admitting that I need help or that I'm hurting, because I've always had to be the strongest in my house. I've always had to be the good girl. I've always had to prove something. I had to prove that I was smart. I had to prove that I was worth of my life, of love, of everything. Everything has been a challenge for me, even though I never really told anybody, because from the outside I was just living the perfect life. When I was a kid, my family was the perfect family, but it wasn't. And like one example is that we literally ran out of home when I was like 7 because of reasons. But I had to fight for pretty much everything in my life. I had to do everything I could to prove that I was worthy. And because a part of me knew that I was worth of love, I was worth of recognition. I knew I could do things. So I was so competitive because I had to prove I was better than that kid or that other kid. I could do everything I wanted to do. If I wanted, I could just rule the world, because that's how I was, you know? Because I need to prove people that I can. I can't think of an example that's not silly right now, and I'm trying not to be silly, so just imagine that I said something that is not silly, okay? Like, I had to prove that I was better than this kid in my history class. I had to prove that I was great at. Like, I never knit anything, but I can make a decent scarf. So yeah, here I am knitting a scarf. And I actually succeeded in lots of things. But right now I don't have that flame anymore. I don't feel, and that's what's really, I think that's what's different. That's why it's been years since I've been able to climb out of this. Because I for one don't think that I'm worth anything. And I can't really picture when it started, but it's eating me alive. It's something that's really hurtful, because for all my life I've been convinced that I was worth something, and I had to prove other people that I was worth something. And right now, I need to prove myself that I'm worth something. And somehow, it's something that I've always had inside of me, because proving others meant to shut up the voice in my brain that said, what if they're right? Maybe you are worthless. But at the same time, I needed and I wanted to fight against this voice. And I did it. And I did amazing things. I'm not gonna lie, it was pretty impressive as a kid. But, and I learned to do lots of different things because, as I said before, I was really competitive. So I was like, oh, you can do this, I can do it better. And I was pretty bratty about it. Like, I wasn't, and I'm not the best person in the world, but I must admit that at least I was reacting. And right now, I'm not. Right now, all I can hear is me saying they were right all along. All of what you did, all of your struggles were for nothing. And I'm not gonna lie, I've always been kind of in love with sadness. Like, I love sad music, I love sad movies and things that kind of hurt you on the inside. I like them. I don't know how to describe this. It probably has some sort of name on this thing, but I've always loved the things that kind of hurt me a bit on the inside. So I'm used to not be bright, like not bright, like not be the most cheerful person because I know I'm not. I love very different things. I love sparkly things, but I love really dark and twisted things as well. And I think it's because one is one thing that I would like to be, and the other is what I feel most close to me. And as I said, I'm sorry, I'm just probably just going here and there without I hope I'm not losing track of things. But right now, I can't see myself approving myself because I don't like how I am. I don't like me not being able to do anything. I'm a failure to me. And I can't help myself. I can't do it alone. And if I upload this video on YouTube, it will probably be a signal that I'm at least trying to do something for myself. I don't love me. I've never really liked me, but at least I knew I was worth of recognition. As of now, I don't think I am. I don't like anything about me, really. I think I'm I think I'm a bad person, in the sense that I probably am wasting my life. Like, a lot of people would probably make a better use of what I have and what I am. What I am is not enough for me to let me react, because there is nothing worth saving. And as I said, I just keep thinking that they were right all along. Everybody was right all along. I'm just not worth it. And I wish to be able one day to just look at past me, at this present me that will be past in the future, and just laugh about it. Just be like, yeah, that felt so horrible, but it wasn't really. I feel good now. It would be nice, but it's not something that it's worth fighting for me right now. And since this is what I feel, and I'm really negative, I can't see joy in things. I don't like to pretend that I'm feeling better, because when I go on YouTube and look for videos to feel better, to just fill my head with things, because so that I don't have to listen to myself or just listen to the sound of silence, which is maybe worse sometimes. When I listen to things on YouTube, I look for positive people, for genuine people, what I perceive as real people, and I want to just listen to them and live happiness through their life. This is really sad, but right now it's kind of working for me, because it avoids me from thinking, so that's right now it works. So I just choose to watch people that are happier than I am, that they don't crap on things, they just live their life, they are pretty much bright and bubbly, but in a real way. Because there are tons of people that I perceive as fake and that just and overall I don't really like positive people. Like, when somebody is too happy, I usually just I don't like them, because why are you laughing? You know? I don't know, maybe I'm just wrong, but that's it. When I'm in that place, I just want to look at people that are happy, because I'm not happy and they are, but they are not happy in your face. They are like just normal, and that's what I would like to be one day, maybe. And but I'm too demotivated to be right now. I'm not making this any better, but the point is that I do like to follow people that are in a better mindset than me. And when I find people who are in my same mindset or worse, or people who always shit on other things or other people's works, I'm just not good. I'm not fine with it, because I don't need other hatred. I have my own crap to deal with. I don't want to deal with other people's crap. I don't want to add negativity to my negativity, because it's endless. I don't want to feel even worse. And as of now, I can't be positive. As I said before, I'm not a positive person overall, but I can't even pretend to be all right. I can't even joke on how crappy I feel as of now, because I don't have the strength to just be sarcastic or just shrug off everything I feel as, yeah, that sucks, but you know, that's life. I can't. And everything I could say or do would probably be salty or black or not pleasant, and I don't want to think that other people might be intoxicated by my own negativity, because I've been poisoned by negative people a lot, and that made me worse. And I think I started to breathe a little more when I just cut all of the bonds that I had with this kind of toxic people. I know I'm poison, I know I'm toxic, I know I'm salty as fuck. I know that. But because I know that, I don't want you to experience my sadness second-handed. I don't want that. I don't want you to think, yeah, life's shit. Yeah, she's right. I want, especially in art, I want people to feel free to just dream, to just do whatever they want, because the I can't. I don't think I can do it anymore. In art and stuff, but I don't want to be too negative about it, because the fact that I can't do it doesn't mean that you can't do it. You can, if you want, you can. You just have to have your motivation, have your goals. You have to believe in yourself, which is what it's really lacking for me. And I don't want to be the people who lets down other people about something that is so important, because art has been my whole life. I'm not even kidding. I've been drawing for my whole life, and I know lots of artists who say I've drawn my whole life, and I personally know at least a couple of person that says, yeah, I've been drawing my whole life, when it's technically not true, because they maybe drew once a week, once a month. Like, they never stopped drawing entirely, but the way I say I've been drawing my whole life, I think it's different from at least those two persons, because those two people, because I had a pretty crappy childhood. I wasn't allowed to go outside. I wasn't allowed to play sports. I wasn't allowed to do pretty much anything. I couldn't even play instruments. I was just, all I could do literally was drawing and reading and watch TV. Those are the only things that I could do, as this. So I grew up with a huge vocabulary that might not show, because this is not my first language, as I said before. Did I say it? Well, yeah, I think you can figure out that this is not my first language, but I grew up knowing more words than a regular child would know, with a good grammar, with I was alone all day, every day. I was allowed to play, but I played alone. So it's either I just played and felt even more alone, or I drew, because I really loved cartoons and I wanted to create my own cartoons. So I used to draw foxes and girls and everything. I used to draw everything as a kid, and that was the only thing that really, it was more fun than playing for me, because it was something that it was reasonable to do alone. Like, if you play dolls and you're alone, you feel like you are alone. But if you're drawing is one thing that you do by yourself. It's not like you need somebody to talk to if you're drawing. Even if it's something that I usually enjoy doing, like playing, drawing and talking at the same time. But I could just create my own world, create my own friends. Just sad, but I just. It was my life, and I had plenty of paper and pencils around, so I could do it, and I do it. I did it for hours and hours and hours every day. And that's one of the reasons why I don't think I'm talented or that I'm better than some others, because that's. I only did one thing, so of course I was better than most of the other kids in my class because I was doing that, only that, you know? And I've never stopped, and whenever I was sad, since nobody was really caring about what I drew, because I was drawing, so there was no need to just look at everything I was drawing. I could just. If I felt like crying, I could just draw people crying. I could just draw people smashing things. It was therapeutic in a way, and it helped me a lot. As a kid and growing up, it helped me a lot. Drawing was really my world. It was my jam. I loved it so much. And then something changed and it stopped being fun as it was before, because I don't really want to blame this on somebody, but something changed and I started to see drawing just as a way to find a work, a job, because that's what I was told to. People started to have so high expectations about me, about my skills, about what I did, and they were all like, "Oh yeah, you're gonna be great. You are gonna be published by this and that." And it never happened. And I spent a lot on schools and I think I failed everybody. And I started the school that I really wanted to do, the comic school, with a wrong mindset, because I was already pretty much poisoned about art at that point. And it went downhill from there, because people had, as I said, they were expecting good things, great things, and I felt like I wasn't enough. And it just changed the way I saw art overall. And don't get me wrong, I do enjoy drawing, but it's not my safe place anymore. I'm now aware that everything I put on paper might be seen, and I don't want people to see how fragile I sometimes can be, or if I'm really pissed at something, so I just try to hide, just to be neuter, to be It's real. Your art isn't you, so you should never feel like it's personal when people comment and critique on your art. But at the same time, what you draw is you. Like, people can see what you like. People can see what you enjoy doing. Like, you like big eyes, so you draw big eyes. You like frilly clothes, so you draw frilly clothes. Some things show, some things of your personality, of your preferences, they show. And I somehow I don't like that. I like seeing it in other people, but I don't like people seeing me, if that makes sense. Because I'm so used to hide my things that when they told me that what I am is there in plain sight, I just started to worry that I don't want people to actually see me. And that's another thing, but. But anyway, as I said, I've always loved art. I've always wanted to be an artist growing up. I wanted to be, I wanted to draw cartoons, basically. So it was like, they never talked about animation in my days. So the closest thing was making comics, and it was the most easily accessible things because I was already doing it. I was just writing speech bubbles over my my foxes and make them talk and stuff like that. So I just wanted to tell my stories. I wanted to have my own characters. I wanted them to be real. That's all I've ever wanted, and all I've worked for. And right now I can't. I know. Maybe if I had the motivation, maybe if I had that spark that let me work as much as I used to, maybe I would succeed. But as of now, I'm so done, so done. I've had so many bad experiences and they hurt me so much. And I just fear like they are going to hurt me even more in the future. So I'm in this kind of stasis. I'll stay here. I'll just wait for things to happen. But I want to go back to filming videos and maybe do more content. And I was told that my channel would be more interesting if I put myself, my personality into it. And that's true because most of the people I follow might not be the best artists, but I really love their personality and I love hearing their opinions, and they just cheer me up, and I like to consider them as friends. And as I said before, I try so much to purge myself from my video content because I don't like what I am. I don't like my being salty, my being negative about everything. But I do have things to say, and I want to show you that I'm a person. So if you're okay with this, maybe I could try doing some sort of vlog kind of thing. that can maybe help me loosen up and you to know more about me if you're interested, of course. And I can give my opinion on more topics, and I will try not to vomit too many hatred. I mean, it's really hard because I'm not a positive person. I'm a pretty sad and gloomy person, and I love sad things. I love broken things, and for some reason, I can't love myself even though I'm pretty broken. But I'm doing it again, right? Okay, no more playing with my feelings, Connie. So, as I said, I will try to put more me into the videos, even though it's really hard. It's really, really hard for series of reasons, because as I said, I don't like people to figure me out, to think they know me, because no, I'm special and this kind of things. I just don't like. I like my privacy. I'm all about gossip, but I like my privacy. And I don't like people thinking they know something about me, because most of the time, what I show you is what I want to show you. And this video is even harder for me because I'm actually showing you some things of me that I don't want you to see. Even though this is kind of cheating because I've already filmed, as I said, 20 clips. They might be even more now that I'm going to edit, but I've filmed so many clips, and in one I broke up into tears, and other ones were too long. And let's just say that I had time to process what I was about to say and purge out some of the things that were too painful for me to say. So this is not 100% honest. Like, it could be more honest, but then this would be like an hour long video, and you don't want to listen to that too. So yeah, that's it. That's why I haven't been there, because I've been struggling with depression, with my self-loathe, and it's so very Tumblr, but that's real. That hurts. I'm that kind of person. I just like not being around when I don't feel like I can. At least give you a smile for my sarcasm, or not being hurt without my sarcasm. So, yeah, I will try to be more online, as I said, and I will try to get more in touch with you if you want. And I think that's it for the why I've been out of YouTube. I don't want to get too much into details about my problems, because they are my problems, and I don't want to burden you. And again, this video would be too long. So this is just case closed. If you want to ask more, just do it in the comment section or DM me. I just think we are done. The other thing I wanted to talk about is art block, and it's my personal opinion, and that's, I think, kind of related to this whole topic. And that might surprise you, but to me, art block doesn't exist. But I've always been in the mindset that if somebody's paying me for something, if I'm doing a job, I need to do the job. So, if people are actually paying me to draw something, even if I don't feel like it, even if it's different from what I have in mind, even if I'm just lazy, I just do it because it's job. It's your work. You do it, right? My personal experience is that if you need to do something, you just do that something. What I feel could be called art block for me is just the lack of motivation, is the lack of a real goal. And in my case, my art block is called depression. Because drawing is not, I don't hate it, but I don't love it either as I used to. And the thought of being hurt again by drawing, by trying, it's so excruciating that I don't even want to try. If it's something for me only, if it's something that it's not work, it's something that is not paid, it's something that is, it's a great opportunity, maybe could lead me somewhere special, I just won't try because it's too painful when it doesn't work out. But I can't draw because I know it. I do it. I draw. Even if I don't feel like it, I'd still draw. And the quality is pretty much the same. And especially if you work on commission, nobody's asking you to like make up a real word. Usually, like you just draw me a girl riding a pig, and you just draw a girl riding a pig. That's all. Like you don't need a degree for that. You just do what you are asked, right? So if you are approaching art as a hobby, that's perfectly fine. If you don't feel like drawing, that's not art blocks. That's just, you want to do other things, and that's okay. It's your right to do something else, right? Even if you are not taking it as a hobby, if you are working through, if you are working towards it being a real job for you, if you don't feel like drawing sometimes, that's good. That's fine. Just allow yourself some free time. Like people often say that they can't draw because they don't have inspiration, but nobody's asking you to be Michelangelo. Nobody's asking you to just be original. Everything you do must be a masterpiece. You just draw for the sake of drawing, you know? That's not art block. That's just making up excuses or having a distorted image of yourself, because it's, even if you think something is gonna be original and full of meaning, it won't be for everybody. It won't be. Chances are that people are just looking at your picture and say, okay, but you put your heart and your soul into it, and to you that was the source of your main inspiration for your latest drawings. You don't just work on inspiration. You just work, you just draw, you just do things, and maybe eventually you just have inspiration. Can't remember who said it, but it was like, inspiration exists, but it has to find you working. So you gotta work, and eventually you will be inspired to do something. You don't give up on something just because you don't know what to draw. That's bullshit. Let's just be honest. You don't want to draw because there are so many things you could draw. You don't know what to draw. You just look around you. There's something you can draw. Or go to Pinterest. You don't like anything you see. Just close your eyes, point at one thing, and just draw that one. You don't like it, that's fine. You're just still drawing. You can't draw just what you like to do, to draw, because otherwise you would be stagnating on the same things over and over again. But that's my opinion. If you just want to draw plants for your whole life, like the same kind of plant for your whole life, just feel free to do it. It's your choice. I won't judge, but as a general reasoning, main thought is that you just have to be honest with yourself and not using art block as an excuse, because it could be just being lazy or unmotivated sometimes, but it could be worse. Like, I know in my case it is worse, and that's why I'm not calling it art block. Because, first of all, I know that I can draw, and I draw even if I'm blocked. Because my block is here, and it's bound to here, and it's called, as I said, depression. So, if you feel like I do, just don't hide beneath the art block. Just seek help. And if you are just, you don't want to draw, if you don't know what to draw, if you are not inspired, to me those are not art blocks. Those are just excuses you make because you don't want to do something. If you have motivation, there is no such thing as art block. And I know that because when I don't have motivations, I feel all of those things, except I force myself, because I'm stupid, to do things even if I don't feel like it. Like, but that's me. You know, you, if you are not looking for professional gigs, if you are just starting out or whatever, allow yourself to your times, to your spaces. Just don't call out art block, because I don't think it's real, and you shouldn't reinforce the concept of it being real, because otherwise we wouldn't have what we have. We wouldn't have art, we wouldn't have comics, we wouldn't have movies, because that person has an art block, so it's not making comics anymore. But no, because it's like writing comics monthly, or is drawing comic monthly. That's it. Of course, motivation is what really plays the game here. Because if you don't have that, what's the point, right? So, but in my case, I know motivation is not only related to art. My motivation is about myself, my life, about everything. And if I can't be real with you guys, I'm talking about that kind of feeling that makes you wake up in the morning and think, crap, still here. And then you either go back to sleep and sleep like all day, or wait patiently for the day to be over so that you can sleep again. And if you feel the same way, please, please, please seek help, and don't do this to you. Find something that can help you. And I know I'm not the best person to talk about this, because I'm still in troubles. I'm still feeling like this. But please seek help. And don't call it art block. If it's something deeper, don't call it art block. And if it's something lighter, this is non-existent. Let's do this. Just let's stop calling this thing art block. Just let's forget about art block, because as I said before, to me it doesn't exist. If you have other things through your mind and you just don't want or can't draw, that's not art block. That's your issues, and they are serious, and it's not something that's preventing you from creating art. It's something that's hurting you from the inside. It's not about art, because you can make art if you want to. That's what professionals do. That's what I can do. That's what you can do. Everybody can do art, even if they feel like they can't. They can't do it. They can do it. You just have to find your motivation. If you don't have that, if you lack that because you have other things into your mind, because you don't feel like it, because whatever, that's when you call it art block. But that's not an art block. That's lack of motivation, as I said. That's not recognizing some problems, or giving more importance to something that is not a problem. Thank you for watching this, and I love you. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, even though I'm sad and gloomy and I talk about depressing things. Because I also make art, so if you're interested, just, come for the gloom, stay for the art, or something like that. And I'm still doing the thing. As I said, yeah. See you later. Bye.